Hi, my name is Ong Xiaohui from 1BITS. I'm going to present our final project coding. The part of coding that I will present is structure order, function order food, structure item price menu, string menu list, Y insert and Y menu UI. We start our coding with preprocessor directive, include IO string, string, IO manipulator, and using namespace standard. In the first part, we use the structure order as the structure tag, order as the name, and the structure member is string this double price integer quantity. And we use the area of structure, which is order food with 100 area. We use the 100 area because we don't know how much will the customer order, so we put the 100 to store the order from customer. And the next is define the menu list. String menu list with 8 area. We have 8 type of menu in our program, so we put the 8 in the area. In area is starter, salad, pasta, mains, chef weekly special, dessert, coffee, and fruity. We save the number of 4. We save the number for each menu list into an area for looping. So we do the integer menu number with 8 area, which is 6, 5, 8, 6, 3, 4, 6, and 4. This is how we declare our structure to hold both string and integer. The next, we also use the structure. Structure name is item price, and the structure member is string this with 8 area, double price with 8 area. To declare the item price, we use the area of structure, which is item price menu with 8 area. The next is declare the menu name and the price. First, we start with the starter. String starter names with 6 area. In the starter, we have the 6 menu. So we put the 6 in the area to store the name of the starter. And integer starter price with area 6. We also put the 6 because we have to show the price for the 6 type of menu in the starter. From the line 35 to line 48, it also show the other menu, which is salad, pasta, mains, chef special, dessert, coffee, and fruity. And the following part is void insert. Void insert is used to insert the name and the price into item price respectively. We use the nested for loop in this part. So if integer I equal to 0, I less than size of menu or size of menu area 0, it will going to integer j equal to 6 equal to 0, j less than menu number. If it's true, it will go into next, which is if I equal to 0, it will display the starter name and the price. If I equal to 1, it will display the salad detail. 2 will display the pasta detail. 3 will display the mains detail. 4 will display the chef special detail. 5 will display the dessert detail. 6 will display the coffee detail. And the last 7 will display the fruity detail. And the last part is void menu UI. This function is to display the menu UI, which is menu user interface. String ARR area is menu list, and integer size is the menu number. So at first we have set out the tab, which is the example in the right hand side. So we have the empty space in at the first. In the second, we put the dashed line. So for integer I equal to 0, I less than 20, because we have the 20 dash in this line, so we put the 20, so it will show the dashed line. And in the next, we see out the end line, so the line will go into the next, and see out the set valve with 22, so they have a place before the menu list and show the menu and end line. And next, we'll also see out the tab and show again the dash line. And last, it will show the menu names. So we put the integer I equal to 0. If I less than size, then we'll see out the I plus 1 and the dot and the menu list and end line. This is example. So I plus 1 equal to 1, so it will show the 1 and starter, 2 is salad, 3 impasta, 4 mains, 5 chef weekly special, 6 dessert, 7 coffee, and 8 foodie. That's all for me. Thank you.
Good afternoon, my name is Teo Soon An. I'm going to present about this 5 part. Okay, first, global concern. First is constant double service tax equals to 0.06, which is 6%. Second, constant double discount equals to 0.1, which is 10%. This is used for promotion when there is a festival like Chinese New Year. If don't have promotion, we can change it to 0. Next is fourth membership function. This function is used to determine whether the customer is a member or not. If he is a member, he will get 10% discount. So we declare the character member price and float discount rate, and then we will ask them whether they are member or not, and store the user's input in member price variable. After that, convert the member price to lowercase because customer may enter an uppercase character, and then we use if else to determine whether the customer is a member or not from the input of the customer. If the member price is lowercase y, then the discount rate will be 0.1, which is 10%. Else, the discount rate is 0. After that, return the discount rate to the main function. This is an example. I will input y for it, and then there is a 10% discount. Next, void cancel order integer and person t. This function is used to cancel order. We declare the integer num and integer quant. Use set field white and left or right to align them properly. So we see out the no quantity, item, and price. We use for loop to display dash line. Use for loop to display the food order and display dash line again. And we will ask which order customer want to cancel. Store in num. After that, use do well to make sure the next user input is not exceed the order quantity. So we use quant to store the quantity of the customer want to cancel. This quant is larger than the order food quantity. It will display exceed order quantity. We use number minus 1 because array subscript always start at 0. If the quant is larger than the order food quantity, it will display exceed the order quantity and start again asking enter the quantity you would like to cancel. After that, use if else to determine whether the customer want to cancel or decrease the quantity of the order. If the food order quantity larger than the quant, that means it will decrease the quantity. If you want to cancel the first order will be replaced by the second one, and the second one will be replaced by the third one until the order number is reached. After that, decrease the order number by 1. Let's see this example. I order 5 mac and cheese and 6 sausage platter. After that, it will show up like this. If I want to reduce mac and cheese by 4, so I'm going to press 1 and enter 4 and no. So now the mac and cheese become 1. So what if I want to cancel the first order? Then I'll press 1 and then enter 5. All mac and cheese. And then they left 6 sausage platter. Next is void receipt integer t float member. Integer t is the number of order. Member is membership discount rate. Declare double discount, member discount, service tax, grand total, and total equals to 0. This is used to display the title of the receipt. Display quantity, item, price in a proper way. Display a line of dash. Use for loop to display the food that customer order. Display the line of dash using this for loop. And we calculate the discount, which equals to total times discount. This is global constant variable, and we calculate member discount by using member times bracket total minus discount bracket, and we find the service tax by using global constant variable, which is service tax times the total minus discount minus member discount. This discount is used for the promotion, and we find the grand total using total minus discount minus membership plus. We find the grand total by using total minus discount minus member discount plus service tax. And then we use set W and left or right to align them properly, and we use fix and set precision tool to make sure that they are displayed in two decimal place. Next, I will show you the example of the receipt function. I order one Greek salad and one pasta salad. This is how the receipt function will display it. That's all from me. Thank you.
Good morning, Dr. Zaria. My name is Tang Weiming, and now I'm going to present the main function of our restaurant menu ordering system program. First, the main function starts with the insert function, which insert the dishes name and dishes prices into the menu list. Then we'll declare the char variable y, z, and cancel for looping purposes, integer variable a, b, c, and t, and float variable member discount index into the integer variable a. As there are 8 types of food, user cannot input other than 1 to 8. So if they insert other than 1 to 8, the do while loop will ask them to insert again. After that, since the user already input the type of food they want, we will refresh the page by using the system CRS again, and then we will display the food type name together with the food type dishes together with their price. And then our program will ask the user whether this is the food type that they want. For example, they choose starters, we will ask them whether it's the food type that they want after viewing the list of food. If they input Y as yes, they can proceed the program. If they insert no, the do while loop will bring them back to the menu UI function to let them choose the food types again. Okay, if the user input Y, the user can input the food index to integer variable B, and then the quantity into integer variable C. After that, the user is asked if they want to put more order, add more order by inserting Y and X into the char variable Z. Now I'm going to present our output. First, it will run the menu UI function which display the food type list, and then we can input the index, for example 1 for the starter, and then we list out the list of starter food together with their price. It will ask the user whether this is the food type that they want. If it's not, they can input N to go back to menu list. But now we're just going to go for starters and insert Y. For example, I want French fries, I insert the index. The quantity I can input 4, for example, and add on, sure. It will go back to the menu UI, the do while loop. And then I want pasta, for example. And then this is the food type that I want. I want the first index, and then I want 3, for example. And then I do want add-ons. I can cancel the order food. Insert N, it will bring me to the receipt. And if I, for example, I want to cancel it, I order too much French fries, for example, I order 4 French fries, I can enter the food index that I want to cancel and the quantity that I want to cancel. For example, I got 4, right? If I insert 5, it will ask me to insert again because I exceed the quantity that I ordered. I can insert 3, for example, to cancel 3 quantities of the French fries. For example, I want to cancel the second order. For example, I want to delete 2 of the bacon aglio olio, and then I want to straight go to payment. They will ask me whether I'm the members that discount 10%. For sure, I'm the members. And then here are the receipt. Give us the total of the order, the discount, and then the member discount 10%, and the service tax add-on, and then the grand total of 1975.